Today I am in the mid-elevation Sierras in a pine forest, and I'm looking for the California Forceps Centipede, which is, in my opinion, probably the most underrated centipede in all of California. Here's a California Forceps Centipede down here. A fairly large one. And you'll notice the terminal legs there, giving them their name, Forceps Centipede. Another thing right nearby the terminal legs that is diagnostic for this genus is the last segment here, the last tergite, is longer than it is wide. So you'll notice already the one we have here is the size of your average Scolopendra polymorpha that you find in Northern California. But just like polymorpha at this size, they do grow quite a bit larger. This one is about halfway grown from being a complete adult. This little alligator lizard was running around in the logs beneath me, and I believe this is a Sierran alligator lizard. And yeah, out here, they have this slight greenish-yellow tinge, which is pretty cool. I've not seen many of these in the past, although there are some places where they're extremely common. All right, buddy. Off you go. There's a big fat scorpion down there. In fact, this western forest scorpion is gravid. Gravid adult female. And this beetle right here is a bumpy death feigning beetle in the genus Nyctoporis. And I believe the species is Nyctoporis carinata. And this is a California endemic. And instead of playing dead like other death-feigning beetles in the genus Asbolus or Cryptoglossa, these guys don't stick their legs out. They sort of just play dead by tucking them in and staying still. Well, I guess, except for the antenna there.
Ah, here's another one. Not as large as the last one, but a good size nonetheless. It's trying to get away. And I am noticing that these centipedes are hanging out in the more moist environments.
I'd like to point out that this isn't the only species of Theatops that we have in California. We also have the eastern United States species, Theatops Pasticus, and that species is found in pockets of the desert here in California. I have shown one here on the channel before. They are quite small.
Out in these woods there are also Brachycybe, though they seem to be fairly uncommon at this time of the year, and I believe this one is rosea, just all by itself.
Here's a smaller one, a juvenile. This is the molt right after the color change they go through. Right now it's more or less the same color as the adults and the subadults are. But when they're a molt smaller than this, they're kind of a cream color, much like a lot of cryptopids are when they're small.
Here we have a Contia, a sharp-tailed snake, and this has got to be the largest one I have ever seen. This thing is an absolute monster.
Finding these abnormally large ones is quite tough too, so I don't know if I should expect to ever see one of these again. And this one must be quite old too, considering all that scarring on the tail. I don't think Contia have evolved to have a tail that's reminiscent of the head, such that they have a better rate of survival when things attack them. But the other kind of common snake that lives out here, the rubber boa, does exactly that. Its tail is meant to be sort of a punching bag for predators.
Okay, sir, off you go.
Ooh, there's one right there. This one is also quite large, maybe a bit larger than the one I saw at the beginning. It seems to be a bit frantic.
And now that we have a larger one, there's something I'd like to show you on the head. That is that these guys are missing eyes entirely. It's characteristic of the family that they belong to, Cryptopidae. So they are entirely blind.
I don't think these guys necessarily evolved from cave-dwelling species, but in the same family there are several species that live in caves, and cave-dwelling arthropods are well known for de-evolving eyes. Here from beneath this log down here, you have a large predatory beetle, Pterostichus llama. I believe this is the largest species in the genus, at least here in California. And this is probably the closest thing to Passimacus or the warrior beetles
that California has to offer.
We have a smaller one here. I was hoping to find an adult, but I'm not seeing many as it is. So, still cool to see this one. There's another Sierran Alligator Lizard there. One with a perfect tail. How am I going to be able to catch it, though? Oops. All right, I finally got you, buddy.
This guy really made me work for the catch. Really pretty one.
Ah, here's a pair of them. And this is not the first time that I have seen two together. But anyway, much like, sorry, I'm trying to focus here and not let them get away. But much like Scolopocryptops, and cryptopids, centipedes, and whatnot, these guys are semi-communal, which means they'll tolerate each other. They won't eat each other unless they're really hungry, and you can find them together if you are lucky. But I don't think they actively seek each other out unless they are mating, or they are peedlings of the same brood, and that would be like first instar centipedes. Anyway, as you can tell, quite difficult to keep two centipedes under control at the same time. So I think I'm just gonna stop rolling here.
Well, that will be all for this video. So, thank you for watching.